going into December, we know that it's championship football. No matter what we did, these first 3 months of the season mean nothing. We have to be able to lock in, focus, and be able to come out with wins to be able to separate ourselves from the rest of the teams in the NFC to try to secure that number one spot so we can get a bye in the playoff.
It's something that I've been dreaming about since I was a kid. Sunday Night Football, Packers against the Bears. I'll be walking out next to Aaron Rodgers. Like, that shit that, as a kid, man, like, it's gonna be nuts.
Going into the Rams week, it being Thanksgiving, this really being our last week before the bye, you know, we played 12 straight games now without having a bye. You know, we knew we just had to be focused and lock in one more week. One more week, seven more days of just locked in, focused, going to work every single day.
Now that we're kind of on that final stretch of the regular season and seeing where the Packers are in the standings and kind of what they have on the line, getting that number one seed. Every single game at Lambeau, you can just kind of feel the intensity building.
Rodgers takes the toss, takes it in. Touchdown, Green Bay. Rodgers inside, Cobb, touchdown.
This being my third year with the Packers, and being able to compare it and contrast it with the past few years that I've had here, I know this is a time that a lot of us just hone in, lock in, and get ready to make that final push for a great run to finish off the season. You know, I really think that this is the time where all the off-season work that we've done, all the time that we spent during camp, all the extra hours that we put in throughout the week start adding up when it gets to the back end of the season, to help us be able to separate from our opponents.
In our locker room, embrace like everybody is like a completely different personality. They're not trying to like mold people into being someone they're not. Like, we just embrace whoever the hell you are, show up on Sundays, ready to play, ready to go, and like let your personality show through your play and your preparation. And I think that's a cool thing that no matter like how long I play or when I get into coaching or whatever, like I'm gonna remember that as something that I want my teams to look like. Just a collective group of people from all different walks of life and wearing that on their sleeves and then coming together on Sundays just to find a way to win.
It's been a pleasure being able to watch Kurt's story unfold from afar over these past few years. I was very fortunate enough to meet him as we both were entering the NFL draft back in 2019. We trained a little bit together. And for him to, you know, one, get here, you know, I was very excited for him to be here, knowing that he was going to be able to reach his full potential with all the guys that we have in our locker room.
So my senior year in college, that's when I kind of started getting more traction. Went undrafted, went through all the combine and the Senior Bowl and all that stuff, ran into Allen a bunch of times throughout the process. Ended up going undrafted to Atlanta, where I was there for 3 years. I had Matt Ryan and Matt Schaub in front of me, so there was not really any chance that I was gonna play. Going into my second year, fast forward, it's 2019. Really get a good grasp on the offense, kind of am able to put my flavor into things of how I play and how I fit into the scheme. We go to the Hall of Fame game and I injure my foot in the fourth quarter, grade 3, turf toe, had to get a full reconstructive surgery and was out for the year. So before there were any preseason games, my whole season was done. So it happened fast, but and 2020 rolls around and it's a COVID year. I get put on practice squad again and kind of back to square one in terms of like financially where I was on the field. Wasn't on the 53 at all or anything like that. Our entire coaching staff gets fired at the end of the 2020 season. I re-sign a futures deal there and am told when the new staff comes in, obviously they're gonna evaluate you, but they liked where I was. Matt Schaub had just retired, so it was just me and Matt Ryan on the roster. This was going to be my chance to be the number two. Didn't expect him to draft anybody and was just going to go and compete. And then I get a phone call from the GM and it was my first time talking to him. And they had been there for 2 months or whatever. So I kind of was just like, oh, like, nice to meet you, whatever. And he was like, sorry, this isn't that type of call. We're going to cut you. I know the guys before liked you, but we're going to bring in some other guys to evaluate. And that was that. So I'm on the street for about 2 months living in Florida, and then I get an invite to the rookie mini camp with the Packers. So I come in and it's me and Chad Kelly, and I beat him out there and I get signed, and then I'm just going through all of OTAs. Jordan was obviously getting all the reps because he was the one without Aaron being here, and they needed to kind of catch him up. And then Blake was getting what was left over. So ending OTAs, I think I got like 3 or 4 reps, and I just kind of went back home and I was like, all right, when training camp comes, like any rep that I get, I'm gonna make the most of. And the first day that we got here for training camp in July, they cut Blake and sent him back home. So from there, it's just like, all right, shit, I'm the third. Fast forward, I don't even know what week we're in right now, but it's late in the season, and I get pulled up and dressed out for my first game dressing in the NFL, and it's been a long time coming.
You know, you look at Kurt's story, and it's, to me, it's unbelievable. It's inspirational. You see the work that this guy puts in every single day. You see the energy, the attitude that he shows up to work with, and, you know, it's contagious. I think that he just really had a great mindset and attitude about attacking each and every single day, and now he's being rewarded for that.
I go into the building like, oh, where the hell is Jordan? Like, is he late? Like, it's a rule 3, like we got fines and everything. That's a rule 3, like he'll be a couple minutes late, whatever. And Getsy is like, well, tested positive. That's our coach, is Getsy, our quarterback coach. And I kind of looked and I was like, oh shit, that means I'm up. There's been plenty of stories of guys and got kind of blueprints of how to do it the long way. And obviously everybody wants things to happen fast, but the long way is not bad. And you get to see a lot of cool shit on the way, get to meet a lot of cool people. And I think you get an appreciation a little bit more for once you do get there, that like I earned this thing and I'm gonna keep fighting to stick around and to keep making the most out of it. The biggest thing that if I could go back and tell myself anything, is you're not who you are today, like who you will be tomorrow and the next day. Like, you keep taking just a little bit at a time. Like, I'm so much better of a player than I was when I was in high school and in college, and I'll be a better player next year. Like, things aren't final when they happen, and there's so much more room to grow as you just keep going.
Going up against the Bears, they're all too of a familiar face. You know, the rivalries there, the intensity, you know, what's at stake for both of us is huge. And I think we both know that going into tonight's game. Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10.
Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to. So yeah, any time that you have a chance to watch a primetime game at Lambeau, it's definitely a really special thing. Especially this weekend where we have the Chicago Bears in town. LABB to the bakery. Some niggas mad that I came up. I know my granny gonna pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. 2 seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills with the new prices. Blue cheese can't kill us. Rodgers fires, caught, touchdown, Alan Lazard. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins in the world, so spinning, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan.
Up at the 44, Alan Lazard. Click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just let my dance. I just take my chance. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down, and I go it again and again. Who is the dummy that died? I'm the coldest of gravity, falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what? Keep it running. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top yeah. Once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10.
When we play teams that are in the AFC, you know, more often than not, we only see them once every year or two or so. So we're not too familiar with them. So going up against them, there's a lot of new stuff that we have to make, in-game adjustments, halftime adjustments on the fly, because they're an opponent that we're not too familiar with. But we know that the two opponents that we have coming up, the Ravens and the Browns, they both have great history and they both had a lot of success this season. And so we know that these are two opponents that we can't take lightly.
Rodgers completes Lazard. First down. And the first completion for 17 yards. Touchdown, Packers!
Playing on Christmas Day in Lambeau Field, I mean, I don't think Hollywood can write a better story.